for allowing me to be a part in this night. We have short cases. We are going to talk about various presentation of pancreatitis. First case is a male patient, 33 years old, presented with abdominal pain for AUS examination. During our AUS examination, we noticed a presence of hyperechoic area and hypoechoic area. This is a very, very common presentation. We find this hyperechoic and more or less well localized hypoechoic lesion. Well, this may be missed by a focal lesion. And in another case, we found the same presentation, hyperechoic area and hypoechoic area. This shouldn't be missed with a dorsal and ventral pancreas. We're going to say a very short note at the embryology of the pancreas is a junction between the fore and mid gut junction. There is a septum transversal, which give us a two pancreatic buds, dorsal and ventral endoderm. Those will fuse to form the pancreas. Dorsal pancreas is form the anterior part of the pancreatic head, body, and tail. A ventral pancreas is form posterior part of the pancreatic head and the uncinate process. This is our, we shouldn't mistake this as a pancreatic focal lesion. Our second case is a male patient, 40 years old, presented with chronic epigastric pain for AUS examination. We found this during our examination, multiple hyperechoic small dots with a posterior shadowing. Each one is more than 2 millimeters. This is the first sign we find. The second one during our examination. Okay, we can move it. Yes. We found a lobularity more than 3 contiguous lobules separated from each other. This is called a honeycombing. It has this characteristic picture. Okay. I think, yes. This is the third one of pancreatitis. No, this is the same calcification. This is the hyperechoic dots which we found. Okay. Yes. And the second one. Yes. This is the main pancreatic duct. We found a large hyperechoic patch with a posterior shadowing, which is a stone found in the main pancreatic duct. It measures more or less 7.6 millimeters. This can give us a very important notice about Rosemont criteria of chronic pancreatitis, which is formed of major A is a hyperechoic foci and the major duct stones and lobularity. We should notice that hyperechoic foci or calcification must be more than 2 millimeters in depth with posterior shadowing. As if it isn't, has a posterior shadowing, this considered one of the minor criteria. And the main duct calculi and lobularity, more than 3 contiguous lobules forming the honeycombing. This is a major A and major B. Minor criteria is other finding. We can find cyst, dilated duct, irregular duct contour, dilated side branch or hyperechoic duct wall, lobularity, hyperechoic foci. Okay. Here we have to diagnose chronic pancreatitis. It is either consistent or suggestive or indeterminate or normal case. Consistent cases with chronic pancreatitis, we should have one major feature plus 3 or more minor features, or one major A plus one major B, two major A features. This is, we can say, a consistent with chronic pancreatitis. Other case, we can say it is a suggestive of chronic pancreatitis if we have one major A features plus 3 minor features, one major B feature with or without, the 3 minor features or 5 or more minor features. In determinant cases for chronic pancreatitis, three or four minor features with no major features. Normal, we have less than two minor features. Our third case is a female patient, 57 years old, recently diagnosed diabetic, presented with chronic epigastric pain with a history of obstructive jaundice. ERCP was done with a plastic stent insertion. Patient was for AUS evaluation. Okay. During the examination, we found a sausage-shaped mass, more or less involving the whole pancreas. Okay, here it again. Yes, this is the mass. It is look like a sausage shaped, more or less involving all the pancreas. This is a characteristic case of autoimmune pancreatitis. We're going to have a very small notice. It is a distinct type of pancreatitis. It is possibly caused by autoimmune mechanisms. In 2011, it was set for five cardinal features, imaging characteristic of pancreas, parenchyma, serology, other organ involvement, pancreatic histology, and response to steroid. It is divided into two types, type 1 and type 2. Type 1 is characterized mainly by seropositive IgG4, pancreatic enlargement, focal solitary mass. Focal solitary mass, which is commonly located in the head of the pancreas, resulting in painless obstructive jaundice. The mass may appear to invade the adjacent vessels, causing upper stream dilatation. Main pancreatic duct is not dilated, good response to steroid, and high relapse rate. Type 2 is seronegative, diffuse pancreatic enlargement, like this case, sausage shaped. Sorry. Main pancreatic duct is narrowed, presented mainly by abdominal pain, symptoms of recurrent acute pancreatitis with raising of the amylase. Our fourth case is a 55 years old male smoker with alcoholic, presented with upper abdominal pain. Lab data shows slightly elevated serum level of lipase. CT showed a second duodenal wall mass with a pancreatic head. Upper endoscopy revealed edema of the duodenum, stenosis of the second part. Okay. This is the AUS examination showing a dilatation of the duodenal wall, usually dilated with second wall, and there is a simple cyst is present in the wall, and enlargement of the pancreatic head. Okay, this is the cyst, and this is the duodenal wall. Okay, this is the case of groove pancreatitis, which is a rare form of segmental chronic pancreatitis, which is present in the groove area. This case usually presented with a gastric outlet obstruction and diagnosis by biopsy, which is negative for malignancy. There are two types, either segmental or pure form. The treatment of a choice, either conservative in the acute cases or in resistant cases, there is a surgical choice of treatment for a pyloric preserving pancreatic duodenectomy. Okay. Thank you.